probably bring you to speed. I'll give a background of Africa needs, and especially with regards to the transition, just to be able to lay background of where we are and what we're doing and the roadmap for Africa and how we came in, and then probably go back to the question that you've asked. Now, we all understand that in Africa we have essentially three key commitments that the governments have put in place to be able to drive this agenda of energy transition. We all are aware of the African Agenda 2063, the UN 2030 Agenda and Sustainable Development Goals, as well as the Paris Agreement on Climate Change. But just to probably bring it a little bit closer home, the drivers of the energy transition in Africa, it could be varying from one place to the other, but the overarching drivers is essentially the rapid decline in renewable energy costs, and also the the improvement in the energy efficiency. There's also widespread electrification, increasing smart technologies, continual technological breakthroughs, as well as we have well-informed policy mechanisms that is being put in place at the moment. And of course, there is the need to have the climate change mitigation. In addition to that, there is also the essence of improving the energy security and socio-economic benefits, or what we call the economic welfare. Just to dig in a little bit deeper on the Agenda 2063, which essentially is summarized into four main areas, which includes the, providing a system, a robust system that will be based on renewable energy, and also to be able to provide, enhancement to localized manufacturing sector, and most importantly, to be able to provide highly qualified human resource. This is very important, because for us to be able to drive this agenda, then we must be able to have people or experts who are able to really guide through, who can be able to provide capacity in those areas. And also to provide integrated energy infrastructure, be it on the gas as well as the and the electricity. I have focused so much on the electricity, because that's my area mostly. But I just wanted to bring a picture on what is really going on in Africa, in particular when you look at the the deployment of renewable, or the harnessing of the renewable energy in Africa. So there is a trend, if you look at it keenly, there is a trend that everyone is thinking about the transition, from one end to the other. But what I want to bring out is that even as we consider this, even as we look at the transition from, a fossil fuel based to renewables, there we have challenges. And probably I want to point out some of the key challenges that we are faced, or we are facing, when looking at this transition. One of the key things that we have identified is that there is this persistence reliance on biomass, on traditional biomass. This has been an issue for a long time, and it still continues to be an issue. But there is also heavy reliance on fossil fuel, in particular when we're looking at generation. And also we have a poor infrastructure. This has been one of the key issues that we have, as Africa, we are suffering from. Without robust infrastructure, then it's not easier for us to be able to achieve the targets or the goals, or probably to increase the energy access as it ought to be in Africa. We also have very low rates of electrification when you're looking at the electricity side, and institutional capacity constraints as well. Now, when you look at all these items and you compare with the, the rapid population growth, then you realize that they are not in phase, and these things need to be in phase. This also goes hand in hand with the weakness in energy governance, which is very critical for us to be able to achieve these objectives that we are looking at. Now, for us to be able to bring this on board, for us to be able to invest, for us to be able to increase the energy access, then we need to access the, substantial financial resources. This has been an issue and a challenge, but of course, lately we have seen many development partners coming in. We have also seen some level of innovation coming in and trying to be able to access this finance from various sources, which has been probably something I could say has been a milestone for Africa. So the roadmap, where are we heading to, and what are some of the things that we need to look at? One is to be able to have an integrated African electricity network. Right now, we are looking at African single electricity market, and we are working towards ensuring that we have a robust electricity market in the whole of Africa. There are other challenges that, of course, underlie this ambitious program, but it is something that can be achievable if we have the robust transmission network. But also, we have to look at the decarbonization of the energy. The systems that is moving towards low carbon energy. Also to be able to have a robust infrastructure for economic and social development, and also to be able to work towards achieving our energy or Paris Agreement that we have already acceded to or agreed to have in mind. Other elements that probably we need to look at is the energy efficiency programs for both buildings and industry as well as transport, and to be able to implement a systematic continent-wide approach to innovation and research and development. Lastly, we need to consider the element of integration, because it's very important, and the political willingness, which is also very critical, a critical element in that. Do we have opportunities in Africa? Yes, we do have lots of opportunities which you can be able to tap into. One of it is the collaboration, or what you call collaborative investment with the locals, being able to contextualize and bring this investment and working together, be it through the PPPs or any other models of investment, which is also very important. And also availability of funding. Now we have various ways of funding these projects, either bonds, crowdfunding, and many other ways. And we've had a number of investors or development partners interested in driving this agenda of energy transition. But also, in particular, looking at the renewable energy, we are seeing the opportunity in be able to define and also to design a good tariffs that will be able to bring on board the renewable energy and support investment. And also there is also now increased awareness and transparent in procurement processes. Other opportunities available is to be able to increase the partial risk guarantees, which now we have many institutions coming on board and are trying to support the investment in these risky areas. We're also seeing some level of unbundling and competition in various countries, which is actually something that is also spreading very fast across most of the African countries. We also have increased research and development and collaborations with other institutions. And just to mention that one of the elements, or one of the ways in which we can be able to increase research, is to collaborate and to capacitate, even through forums like this one, so that we can make people aware of what is going on and what really needs to be done. So this is one way of informing and also capacitating the continent. That also brings me to the last point, which is strengthening regional capacity and regional cooperation. There is no country that can work, as an island or even a continent. We need to work together. We need to look at what other people have done. And also we need to collaborate with like-minded institutions to be able to achieve this. So I think with all this, then it is possible for us to drive this agenda of energy transition, which again, I believe, that should be done in a way that is systematic, I could say slow but sure, so that we can be able to know where we are starting from and where we're heading to. Thank you so much. That's all I have for today.